Hey everybody, it's Connor McIver. I want to show you how to set up a pop-up search with Spatial Match. So that's what we're going to do. Let's go ahead and get started here. You see that I've written this blog post. This is one of our very typical updates. And I want to show the five-bedroom foreclosure pool, the foreclosures, bankrupt properties, pre-foreclosures with pools here in the SCV. Well, if you have Spatial Match, then you'll be able to do this very simply. And a couple things. If you have the plugin, of course, use the Spatial Match system. You'll have this icon showing up here. So now you need to find out where you want to put the link or the map. And there's a couple options. You can either have the map embedded into the blog post page, but our width for our content's about 600 pixels wide, something just to consider. If in fact you're using it for that purpose, then you might want to do a full page rendering that's around 900 pixels. So what I'm going to do is I'm not going to choose that option. Let me show you what I'm going to choose. I'm going to go ahead and click here. Now, I already built a map. If you haven't built a map, you're going to want to do that. And what you'll be able to do is you move the map around, choose all the criteria you want to have rendering on the map, and then you save the map by whatever name. I did this earlier, and what I did is I made our search the five-bedroom pool homes, foreclosures, and pre-foreclosures here in Santa Clarita. I can choose the embedded map. When I do that, I want to make sure that I don't go over the width of my blog, wherever my text goes. If I do a full page rendering, then I can go all the way with it. I can do 100%. If I don't, then I have to adjust it. But I'm going to show you the pop-up map, and I think that's good. You can use the standard web link or a button. I'm going to go with the standard web link. The difference is the button's going to be kind of a gray background, a black text. It's going to have a box form. It's going to look like a box. You can use a different title in here if you want, or I can just use this one, which I'm going to choose. And then the width of the pop-up will adjust to whatever screen I'm using. So for example, I can go 100%, and you can either put pixels minus the percent sign or 100%, and then you click OK. It's going to go ahead and embed it in here, and then I'm going to go ahead and save this. And once I save it, then I'll be able to view it. And here we go. So I'm going to go ahead and view this. Now what you're going to see is you'll see the link. It's going to be light blue, and it's going to show us what I've just built. So once I do that, then it's going to load the page, and here's the link that I just built that wasn't there before. So once the page loads, once I click this, it should give me a full page rendering as it is, or as it does, of that particular search. How the client gets away from this and wants to move back and read your posts, they can do that very easily. You know, they can scroll down here, but how they do it, they're going to click on this X. The reason why it's kind of covered right now just happens to be because I'm actually in my blog, so you see my dashboard popping up here at the top. So that's what you're seeing. But these are all the five bedroom distress type properties here in the Santa Clarita Valley. They're either going to be bank-owned foreclosures or pool homes. And that's how you do it. I hope you're doing good. We will do more tutorials later, and I hope I didn't move too quick, but I wanted to keep it as close to 3 minutes as possible. I've gone over. I got to go. Take care. Bye.